Hey there, it's Ashley Perkins. Welcome back to the best place to build income, influence, and impact for your business or brand online. If you're new here, make sure you subscribe because I share new social media and brand strategy tutorials every week. So it's no secret that Facebook Live is the easiest way to get found by your target audience, build trust with them, and convert them to clients or customers. But with all of the big brands and influencers out there stealing the spotlight with their live streams, how are we supposed to stand out and capture our audience's attention? By creating custom branded overlays and slide shares for your Facebook Live using a streaming service like OBS Studio. Now, there is a bit of a tech curve with this software, but don't worry, I'm going to walk you through exactly how to create your branded content and overlays, then set them up within OBS for your Facebook Live stream. Alrighty, let's first get started by creating your custom overlay that's going to appear on your Facebook live stream so you can stand out from the crowd. And one of my favorite tools to use for this is Canva. Canva comes free and on a paid business plan. I have actually upgraded to the business plan and love it, but you can still do everything that you'll see here using the free plan. So let's get started. You'll want to make sure that you're using custom dimensions so you fit the Facebook newsfeed properly. And the custom dimensions for a Facebook live stream are 1200 by 675 pixels. And then all you've got to do is click design. Canva is going to give you a blank template in the size that you've specified so you can start creating your custom overlay for OBS Studio and make it entirely your own. Already, and I am totally happy with the way that this looks. You can get as creative as you want and add as much text and as many other elements as you'd like, but for me, this works perfectly. And I know it won't take away from my live video, it'll be the perfect accent. So I'm going to go ahead and title that and download it. And when I download it, I'm just gonna make sure that I download the PNG version with the transparent background. And that way it won't block me when I'm using it as an overlay on OBS Studio. Another great way to stand out in a crowd of Facebook live streams is to create a custom live stream that is both educational and entertaining, and a great way to diversify your live stream from all of the other live streams currently happening on Facebook is to create a slideshow or custom slides to also include intermittently from your face-to-face broadcast with your audience. So it just adds an extra layer of expertise, entertainment, and education for your audience. And it also gives you a break from being on camera for the entire time. So to create a slide like the one you're looking at right here, you'll want to again input the custom dimensions into Canva, which are 1200 by 675. And then you'll have a blank template as you saw earlier. And then you can just go ahead and add any elements you want, like photos and text and any other tips and tricks that you may be talking about during your live stream. So again, you're breaking up the content of your live stream, also giving your audience something tangible that they can perhaps take notes off of. And again, like I said, as an added bonus, it gives you a break from being on camera. Now for these, you won't have to worry so much about downloading the transparent background because we're using them as slide decks, and that essentially means that they're going to cover the entire screen so you will not be visible. So again, you want to just download the PNG version as is and save it to wherever you'd like. So now that you have your custom overlays and slides ready to go, it's time to get started setting up your Facebook live stream in OBS Studio. If you haven't already, go to obsproject.com or just Google Open Broadcaster Software and you can download it for Windows, Mac, or Linux completely free. And then you're all set to get started streaming live to Facebook using this free tool. So once you have OBS downloaded, you just want to open it up because we're going to get it set up for your Facebook live stream. So think of OBS Studio a little bit like Photoshop. I mean this in the sense that there is one profile open, which you can see over here, which is a scene, and then you upload multiple sources to that one scene, which are kind of like layers. They can be moved on top of one another, deleted, and shown at different times based on your controls and commands. So because we're going to be live streaming to Facebook, we of course want to add a video input source. You want to go ahead and select your device. Obviously, you want to make sure you're using the most high-end device you have, whether that is your computer's webcam or another webcam that you've purchased. Hello. And you just want to make sure you're always double-checking your presets because Facebook's preset is 1280 by 720. You don't want anything above or below that because it's going to affect the quality of your video. Another thing I always encourage everyone to do is select use buffering, and that basically means that if somebody has a poor connection or if you yourself have a poor connection at the time of your live stream, anybody tuning in will not miss a beat. So if you tend to freeze and then resume the video 5 seconds later, they'll be able to catch everything that they missed in those 5 seconds as opposed to just chunks of your live stream being missing. So do make sure you select use buffering before you get started with your video capture. So once your video capture is all set, you may notice some black space down at the bottom, and you can just go ahead and expand the corners of your video capture image however you like it, whether you want more or less of one thing or another in the camera or in view at one point. So I like the way that looks right there, so I'm going to leave that as is. So normally now what you would do is input your audio device. I'm using my high-end mic to record this video tutorial for you, so I won't be able to use it for my Facebook live stream also. So I'm just going to allow this Facebook live stream to use my webcam's audio, which you can see right here. But if you wanted to change your audio input device, it's as simple as just selecting audio input capture and finding your device as we did with the video capture device. Since I won't be adding another audio capture device, I'm going to start and upload my images like my overlay and the slide that I'm going to be sharing during my live stream. So I want to select image. And just find that file. I saved mine to my desktop. There it is. And again, you'll see that it uploads in a different location than I would ideally like it to be on my Facebook Live. So I'm just going to grab it and drag it down to the bottom here. And that looks great to me, so I'm going to leave that as is. And now I want to upload my slide, which I'll be sharing to educate my audience. So again, I want to select image. There we go. And again, you will have to do some tweaking of this to make sure it fits the screen properly. There, that looks great. So as I was saying, these are like layers and can be moved around to your liking. But when you're on your Facebook live stream, all you simply have to do is click this little eye, and whatever image in your slide share you're showing will disappear. So you could essentially upload a sequence of those slide images one after the other in the way that I just showed you. And all you have to do is have OBS open during your live stream, which you already will have to have. And you can just walk through each image and click that eye as you go along to show an image and then take it off screen, and then show the next one and take that one off screen, and so on and so forth. So I've hidden that image for now, and this image you're seeing right here is what's going to appear when I go live on Facebook. So let's get started with that right now. Open Facebook, your business page, your profile, or a group in Google Chrome, and you want to go to your publishing tools and into your video library. You're going to see a button either up here in the top right, or yours might be over in the left here, and you want to select create a live video. What you want to grab from this is the stream key, so make sure you select it entirely and copy it. Head back into OBS Studio and select settings. So under stream, you just want to make sure that the service is in fact Facebook Live, and you paste your stream key in there. An important thing to note about this is that the stream key that Facebook gives you is only good for about an hour. So if you plan to go live in the future, don't do this until before you plan to go live. Otherwise, you may have to start the process over, grab a new stream key, and input it into OBS Studio. So make sure you're doing all of these steps immediately prior to going live on Facebook to make your life a lot easier. So once you've pasted your stream key, you just want to make sure that you're checking the output. Facebook likes a bitrate of 2500, so that looks great there. Double check the video. All of our resolutions and our output resolutions look great here. Just make sure that you're seeing these numbers too. And then you can go ahead and save your settings. So now that we're ready to start streaming, you want to select Start Streaming and go back into Facebook, and OBS is now going to be preloading your stream into your Facebook Live. Now, what I suggest here is that you plug a pair of headphones in to avoid any audio feedback. As you may have heard, I did have a little bit of feedback there. So you just want to make sure that you have your headphones. You don't have to necessarily put it in your ear, because I can hear right here that these are in fact working and picking up my audio. So again, you just want to take a second, title your live stream, make sure it's super compelling and completely indicative of what you're going to be talking about. For the sake of this tutorial, I'm just going to call it Testing Facebook Live on OBS Studio. And I can just copy that and put it as my video title down here as well. You'll also want to input your tags that are relevant to the topic of your video. But since this is an example, I'm just going to show you how to go live. So once you have all of your information inputted, all you have to worry about is clicking go live. Okay, so as you can see, we are live here on Facebook, and we can see people coming in and out. The only thing that I do want to note is that you won't be able to see comments come in real time. So what I recommend doing is just opening another page where you can see your business page profile or group, and just to make sure that you're there monitoring the comments and engagement that you get on your live stream. And you can also do this from your mobile device if you have it accessible while you're going live. So now let's get into how we can up-level it using our overlays. Now that you can see that I'm live here on Facebook and everything's going well, everyone can see and hear me, just open your OBS Studio back up, and remember, when you want a slide to appear, all you have to do is uncheck that eye. And if you come back over here to Facebook It is a bit of a time delay, but eventually it's going to pop up on the screen and you'll see it right there. I've got my tips up there for using OBS Studio and Facebook Live, the tips that I explained to you earlier, and that is Facebook Live using OBS in a nutshell. So when you're done wrapping up what you're talking about, all you have to do is click End Live Video and you're done. And finally, just make sure you head into OBS and select Stop Streaming.
There you have it. Now you have a way to step up your game and stand out on Facebook Live using OBS Studio. And if live streaming is a video marketing strategy that you want to get started with, click the link below this video to learn more about my e-course, Learn to Live Stream. Inside, you'll find my top to bottom strategies for leveraging Facebook Live to get found by your target audience, build trust with them, and increase conversions. And as always, if you like this video, please hit the like button below and share it with your friends. I'll see you in the next video.